Watch your proximity meter to see if you're getting closer to the cluster or farther away.
Grass and coral arrangements. Anybody? It can only be Ode to Joy.
There's one nearby, Kinsey. I am safe to approach?
Safe-ish. Just keep getting them.
But when we get to... Ah, this song is magnifique. Join me in a duet, Kinsey.
No, I don't think so.
I insist. I'll even let you be the cat.
Not gonna happen.
We come together. You're lying, Kinsey. And you know... It ain't fiction.
No.
Kinsey, your president wants you to do this.
Fuck that.
Your lack of esprit de corps is noted, young lady. I shall regret this, but how is it amazing?
It seems that anything that broke the normal rules of the simulation deposited loose data that can be incorporated into your programming.
Remarkable. I am following your train of thought.
But since the data is so fragmented, it doesn't leave behind a complete subroutine to loop into your code base.
Alas, we are derailed again.
Ugh. It's simple. The more clusters you get, the more you can upgrade and alter your abilities.
Now we are speaking the same tongue.
Damn it.
And now... A selection from the Bard's Othello. Iago. Thus do I ever make my fool.
Is three clusters sufficient?
Still missing some key fragments. Get one more and we'll see.
If I would time expend with such a snipe. But for my sport and...
So if these data balls...
Clusters.
Oui, clusters. If they can be so useful, why are not Zinyak's people out gathering them?
Why would they need them?
To amplify his power? Did you not say these clusters are amazing?
If Zinyak wants to change the code for his people, he can just... He wrote the simulation!
But he is not concerned about... Oh, forget it. If this works, then it works.
Probably better that way.
Let me see.
That bridge
now.
Explosion totally.
To get his place and to plume up my will in double nickel. Now, how?
Mon Dieu! Zinyak demolished my apartment!
That place should have been condemned a long time ago.
I thought it had, how you say, character?
He hath a person and a smooth disposed to be suspected, framed to make women false. The Moor is of a free and open nature that thinks men honest. That but seem to be so, and will as tenderly be led by the nose as asses are. I have it. It is engendered. Hell and night must bring this monstrous birth to the world's light. Ah, Iago.
Should be enough. Let's see what I can do here. Check your hub.
However, such a claim is often made by Philistines trying to ingratiate themselves to their social brethren. No.
Thank you.
This feels magnifique.
Here, let me load up a training program for you to test your powers.
Test them how?
The code says you can jump long distances and run at super high speeds. How about starting with a small jump? Okay, try focusing on charging your jump. That should get you higher.
How am I expected to jump up that?
Try pushing off from the wall each jump.
You expect me to climb the walls?
It'd be more accurate to say you can jump up them repeatedly.
No difference. C'est bon!
This time I blew the buildings apart. Try making that jump.
I'm liking this.
Okay, now for the big test. Use your super speed to get a running start and leap to that opposite building.
You gotta be joking.
Just try it. See? You did it! I think I figured out how this works. Run along the path collecting the power orbs, which should boost your new speed. Every time you hit a checkpoint, you'll be able to stay in the program a bit longer so you can reach the end. Though you probably want to avoid the firewalls along the way. Good luck!
So where did this all come from?
Don't know, but it seems like when you break through any checkpoints along the race, the district's reality matrix will overload a little.
Forgive me, Kinsey. I don't understand your nerd shit.
It means the simulation doesn't like it, and we're able to control the area.
Ah, makes sense.
It did the first time I said it, too.
See? We're totally simpatico.
Lies.
Nobody does it better. Deepest Scorecard. Imbecile. Thank you.
I'm so sick of having to pick up Jenna. That's it.
And now, for your listening pleasure, I've brought in one of my favorite scene partners, the lovely Jane Valderrama. Allow me to set the stage. Romeo, a Montague, has snuck into a gala being thrown by the rival Capulet family. As if that he first sets his eyes on his heart's greatest desire, the vision known as Juliet. If I profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine, the gentle fire is this. Two blushing pilgrims, ready stand to smooth that rough touch with tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much, which mannerly devotion shows in this. For saints have hands that pilgrims' hands do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Have not saints lips? And holy palmers too?
Woohoo! Oh, all right!
Lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh, then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do. Pray. Grant thou, lest faith turn to despair.
Yes!
Saints, do not move, though grant for prayer's sake.
Then move not, while my prayer's effect. From my lips, by that, my sin is purged.
Yes!
Then have my lips the sin that they have took.
Sin from my lips? Oh, trespass, sweetly urged. Give me my sin again. He kisses her again.
You kiss by the book.
Thank you, Jane. Ravishing as always. Stay tuned, faithful listener. More classic music and literature is coming your way.
Woohoo! All right!
Hello, friends. Zinyak here to educate and to entertain. That was Jacques Offenbach's Orpheus in the Underworld.
Yeah! always...